everything I do is special because it's done through my donor heart.
मैं उनके लिए pray करती हूँ कि उनकी life बहुत आसान हो, बहुत सारी उनके लिए खुशियाँ आए, सब उनकी life एकदम best हो.
If we could see a physical queue of patients waiting for organs, we would realize the magnitude of the crisis, the darkness and loneliness, anxiety and fear that surrounds the lives of lakhs of Indians. Battling end-stage organ failure, their only hope is a donor who is a match.
ਉਹਦੇ ਵਰਗਾ ਤਾਂ ਫਿਰ ਕੋਈ ਹੋਰ ਭਲਾ ਕਰ ਹੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਸਕਦਾ ਜੀ.
ਇਹ ਜੋ ਸਮੇਂ ਗੁਜ਼ਾਰਨਾ ਪੜਤਾ ਹੈ ਇਨਕੀ ਤਕਲੀਫ ਦੇਖ ਕੇ, ਇਸੇ ਲੱਗਤਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਅਗਰ ਇਹ ਡੋਨੇਸ਼ਨ ਮੈਂ ਜਲਦੀ ਮਿਲ ਜਾਤਾ ਹੈ ਤੋ ਇਹ ਤਕਲੀਫ ਇਨਕੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਤੀ.
ਚਲਤੇ ਚਲਤੇ ਹਮ ਸਭ ਇੱਕ ਨਾ ਇੱਕ ਦਿਨ ਆਪਣੀ ਮੰਜ਼ਿਲ ਤੱਕ ਪਹੁੰਚ ਹੀ ਜਾਏਂਗੇ. ਪਰ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਮੇਂ ਆਜ ਵੀ ਲੱਖੋਂ ਲੋਕ ਅੰਧੇਰੇ ਮੇਂ ਖੜੇ ਹੈਂ ਅੰਗੋਂ ਕੇ ਇੰਤਜ਼ਾਰ ਮੇਂ.
ਦਾਨ ਦੇਨੇ ਮੇਂ ਕਈ ਬਾਧਾਏਂ ਹੈਂ, समझ की कमी, परंपरा, भय, आस्था, फिर भी ये छोटी सी भेंट हमें, आपको, दुनिया भर को ऐसे संतुष्ट कर जाती है कि जिसके बारे में कोई सोच भी नहीं सकता है.
Join me in taking the pledge to donate your organs because we all have more to give.
I've pledged my organs because I believe I have more to give.
देश का सिपाही मुझे देने का अभिमान, देता हूँ अपनी जवानी, देता हूँ अपने प्राण. मैं देश का सिपाही मुझे देने का अभिमान, देता हूँ अपनी जवानी, देता हूँ अपने प्राण. जब मैं
I think everybody should really get it into their heads that this is the only way we can really, really go out and say, hey, this was mine, now it's yours.
देने का अभिमान, देता हूँ अपनी जवानी, देता हूँ अपने प्राण. मैं देश का सिपाही मुझे देने का अभिमान, देता हूँ अपनी जवानी, देता हूँ अपने प्राण. जब मैं ना रहूं तब भी मैं.
NDTV and Fortis this year in the national capital to encourage and motivate at least 1,000 people to donate their organs. You are partnering and are on board for this initiative. Why do you feel this initiative calls for that awareness and that urgency?
Snigdha, I mean, statistics speak for themselves, right? We know for a fact that about 5 lakh individuals die every year waiting for an organ, and that's not a number that can let many people rest easy, right? So Fortis as the leading healthcare provider of the country, when we looked at these statistics, when we looked at India's organ donor rate, when we started this exercise 2 years ago, I'm talking about the organ donor rate was 0.5 per million population. That's not even one. For a nation of a billion, we do not even have one per million, right? And that's when we decided to take it up as a cause.
It's not just at schools and at young level, but also at hospitals, that young doctors and nurses need to be aware about this because they are the ones, the point person who counsel the patients. How important and what steps are you taking at Fortis to do that?
It's not just young doctors and young nurses, young administrators, it's all of us, right? Because we have a billion people here and there are a lot of while there are a lot of people understand it exceptionally well and understand all the details behind it, there are a lot of misconceptions as well. Everything from old superstitions, old ideas, old mythology, things like that, all the way to what would my treatment be like, right? What would my loved one's treatment be like if I've already committed to giving organ? So the reality is that we are committed to saving every life to every extent that can be done. And I think educating everybody around within the hospital system in terms of what happens, how it happens, how sensitively it's done. Right? It's done in a very respectful manner.
Why does this initiative resonate so much with you?
Definitely, like, as I'm a football player, a sports person in Accurate, the need, like, we can get injury at any time, and the importance of getting an organ, it's really, like, massive for a sports person or generally any citizen who is in need. Definitely an organ who can donate it, definitely then they should, and this initiative should be, like, spreading more and more awareness to the people in rural, urban, everywhere, so that people should be knowing and they can donate when others are in need.
Came forward, donated.
Why is it important, you know, that youngsters like him, us, they come forward? Because the young generation perhaps doesn't have that apprehension.
Well, I think their world is very much like today is a different world from when we were teenagers at that age. And when you have incentives like you are offering right now for a public participation, for a bigger goal, then youth is the future. They have to sort of sensitivize themselves and others in their area of influence.
I think it's really important, my dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, and young children. All of us have to pool our resources together, and those resources to begin with are ourselves. And if we all pledge our organs to those who would need them whenever, we should be absolutely ready. Where is the hesitation? After all, we must learn to live together for each other.
We are here at Phoenix Market City in Kurla, Mumbai. We are a country of a billion people. Surely we could have more donors. Where do you think the problem is?
People who are left over after a patient demises and he's ready for donation of his organs, responsibility falls on his parents, siblings, etc., etc. They're a bit squeamish about opening up the body, taking out its organs and giving it to people. But what they must realize is that there is a continuity. Forget money and the commerce of it. It's the sheer gratitude of the people who you have given an extension of life to. And a part of your loved one and a part of your relative or dear one lives on in the patient who has actually been given a lease of life. Now, isn't that a wonderful, beautiful idea itself?
So your first thoughts on organ donation is what I'd like to know from you.
I really feel like organ donation should be standard practice, especially in a country as populous as ours, and in a country where we have miles to go before we see healthcare available to all. So I would urge people not to be stingy with their body parts after their death, because it's literally of no use to anybody, but it could save a life.
खेल में तो हम हमेशा सेकंड इनिंग्स के बात करते हैं, कमबैक के बात करते हैं, ये सब शब्द से आपका पहचान बहुत पहले से ही है, लेकिन लाइफ में कमबैक, लाइफ में सेकंड इनिंग्स, ये भी एक बड़ी बात है।
बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जो लाइफ में सेकंड इनिंग्स खेलते हैं और लंबे अरसे तक खेलते हैं। अगर उनको राइट टाइम पर अगर राइट डोनर मिल जाता है, अगर राइट टाइम पर अगर उनको जो उनको चाहिए होता है वो अगर मिल जाता है तो सेकेंड इनिंग्स भी खेल सकते हैं।
awareness programs like this happen, I'm sure the numbers are going to increase.
Controlled on single drug for hypertension, they can donate their kidneys.
Education and awareness also makes a lot of difference.
This campaign that NDTV has started has really helped a lot of people.
We are a spiritual country. I think we should say that this Daan is the best Daan.
It is a policy crisis. It's a national crisis. But do you think we are lacking behind when it comes to policy? Or what is it that the number of donors versus the number of people who are waiting for a donor, the difference is so high?
Yes, I agree. Difference is so high. If you consider the kidney failure patient, whoever they are waiting for organ, or a liver failure patient, whoever they are waiting in the lane, a heart failure patient, whoever they are waiting in the lane for the organ donation, and especially the lung failure patients. Considering the number of road traffic accidents and related mortalities, if you consider only road traffic accident, other than before considering any other causes of the brain death, the road traffic accident deaths are very high in India. Compared to those things, the organ donation and awareness regarding the organ donation in our country is very poor. Organ donation is not happening to the mark, and the people, whoever they are waiting in the lane for the organs, are suffering. And especially these patients, whoever they are in the irreversibly diseased state, like a brain dead state or something like that, if they are our loved ones, near and dear ones, we should consider donating the organs to save someone's lives. By doing so, we should try to look our loved one through someone's eyes, someone's heart, and someone's body.